I have a confession to make. I'm a developer and I only use one monitor.
Damn!
Yeah, I know. Shocking, right? I feel like every developer out there insists that you need at least two monitors to work efficiently. But after years of trying, I've realized that it just doesn't work for me. Now, I'm not saying that everyone should follow my approach. Some people thrive with multiple monitors, and if that works for you, keep doing it. But I want to share why it never worked for me, and maybe it will give you a different perspective. If we go back to when I was fresh out of university 5 years ago, one of the first things I did when I started getting a paycheck as a software engineer was to upgrade my desk setup. It was in the midst of COVID, so I was working mostly from home, and I wanted to make my setup comfortable, so I ditched my cheap 180p monitor for a nice Ultra HD. I got myself a nice standing desk, some new tech, and then, influenced by other devs saying you couldn't work without a second monitor, I decided to get one too. And it was great, super useful for like front-end development to have like the web page open while coding on one screen and on the other screen seeing my changes in real time. Then I started thinking, what if I had another monitor? You know, I could keep my Slack open or maybe my terminal. It should be useful, right? So I got a third monitor and wow, I could see everything at the same time. At some point, I even had four monitors, three big 7-inch screen, plus my laptop display. I could have so much windows open, but somehow it still never felt right. I tried every possible combination, one vertical monitor to see more line of code, two side by side, one on top, plus my laptop screen, but no matter what, I always felt like I could still use more space. And then I started to realize something. Yeah, I could see more and access so many more applications at once, but all of this was just distraction. I'd be coding on one monitor, have a YouTube video playing on another one, Slack conversation open on the third, and my attention would constantly switch between them. I was never fully focused on my code, never fully listening to the video, and always keeping an eye on group chat to not miss a thing. And even though I knew all of this was just distracting me, I couldn't help myself. I just couldn't stand seeing a monitor that wasn't being used, so I kept convincing myself I could multitask. But at some point, I just couldn't anymore. I had enough. Around that time, I was reading this book called Digital Minimalism. It talked about intentionally choosing technology that supports your values and mindfully optimizing its use. It kind of makes you reflect on your habit and help you do a like digital decluttering to eliminate what could be considered low-value distraction. And reading this book made me a lot more self-aware about how I was using technology and, you guessed it, how I was using my screens. So I decided to declutter and try an experiment. I removed one monitor, then another one. And even with just two monitors left, I tried to be more disciplined, telling myself I wouldn't use them for distraction. But somehow I kept opening a YouTube tab or leaving Slack or Discord or like Messenger open. And it constantly pulled my concentration away from work. So one day, I just said, you know what? Let's just do this. One monitor, no more multitasking, just one thing at a time. And I tried it for a month, then two, then three, and I just kept it. I liked it and it kind of worked. You definitely need to change a bit the way you work, like you become a master of keyboard shortcuts, command tab become your best friend, It also helped a lot when I discovered this wonderful software on Mac, Alt-Tab, to switch between Windows instead of just apps. I still don't understand why macOS handled this way by default. It's just weird. You also start to rely a lot more on multi-desktop feature, which is one of the reasons I got myself a nice Magic Trackpad. But overall, this whole setup has really helped me stay focused on one task at a time. It's day and night. If I'm coding, I'm coding. If I'm watching a video, I'm just watching a video. If I'm checking some email, all my attention is on email. And something I didn't even expect about this setup was that I felt way less fatigued at the end of the day. No more constantly moving left and right between screen, no more attention split between two things at a time. It made a much bigger difference than I expected. But for all of this to work, I think there's like one caveat. You need a good monitor. And I think I may have found the perfect one for it. It's actually the first monitor specifically designed for us, programmer. It's the BenQ RD320UA, a 4K 32-inch screen, which is important for a single monitor setup because if you need to work with, let's say, two windows open, like for front-end development, you need a lot of real estate, which 4K on a big screen makes it possible. One of the biggest thing I love about this monitor is its different modes, like one made for coding that makes everything sharper and easier on the eyes. Plus, the contrast is really good, so text just pops. It also has this nano matte panel, which is great because it cut down on reflection and glare. One time I had an internship in office where I was working with an old Apple screen that has this glossy display, and because there were these big windows behind me, it was actually really hard for me to focus on what was on the screen due to all the reflection. So ever since, I always look for nano matte displays, just so much better. The monitor also makes it super easy to tweak things with like this little function bar. I can quickly change color settings and adjust the blue light filter, which is great for late night coding sessions. Another cool thing, especially if you work in a dimmer room, is this subtle backlight they call Moon Halo. It just gives off a soft glow behind the monitor, and you can switch between warm and cool tones, which really help reduce eye strain. And also for efficiency, this monitor has a built-in KVM switch, which is super cool if you have multiple computers like me with my MacBook Pro and my Mac Studio that I constantly switch between. Even though it's just one screen, there's also this Dual View Plus feature that lets you show two different color modes side by side. So if you're working with something where color accuracy is important on one side and you need clear text on the other, you can do that all on the same display. So yeah, the biggest thing you need to have to make a single monitor setup work for you is to have a good monitor. And if you're a developer like me, you really can't go wrong with the BenQ RD320U. Full transparency here, BenQ did send me this product to try it out, but this video is not sponsored and they didn't pay me to say anything. All opinions are my own. Like I said at the beginning, the single monitor setup might not be for everyone. Maybe if you have a lot of self-discipline, which I don't, and you're able to avoid distraction, multiple monitors might work fine for you. But if you're like me and you find yourself constantly distracted, maybe you should give the one monitor setup a try and see for yourself. It does take some time to adapt. At first, you feel lost between all your windows and apps, and it can be frustrating, but if you keep doing it for at least a week or two, you become a master of keyboard shortcuts and everything becomes more and more streamlined. you start to feel way more focused. And another advantage is that I feel like it makes it easier after that to work from anywhere because you're used to just work with one monitor. So now working with just your laptop in, let's say, a cafe, for example, is no problem. Plus, I think it also gives you a way more aesthetically pleasing desktop. I've been optimizing mine for the past few years and I finally feel like I've got it just right. And you can watch my video right here for a full breakdown of my setup.